thinking about her, I'm thinking about me, thinking about us, and then we don't be in my eyes. So it's only just a dream.
She can see what I see, but every time she asks me to, it's only just a dream.
When I see her travel back,
welcome to Penhook and Needles podcast, episode 87. I'm Marlisha, one of your hosts, also known as Lady Fornico.
And I am Talia, also known as Franciscan Gypsy on Ravelry, Clerk, and just about everywhere else.
So welcome aboard. I am known as Lady Fornico on Ravelry-related sites and Fiber-related sites. I'm also known as Shadowlight One or by Marlisha on my writing sites.
We are in a changed location. We're in the living room instead of in the sunroom because it is pretty cold.
It's pretty cold outside. It was in single digits this morning. I think we're finally in double digits of about 12 or something like that. And it's been pretty breezy, so wind chill, who knows. Anyway, want to welcome all new and returning viewers. We are glad to have you with us.
First of all, our song was the cool matchup, Just the Way You Are, / Just a Dream, that was sung by the Bard and Bellas and Pitch Perfect. Mm-hmm. I don't know who originally sang Just a Dream, but Just the Way You Are was originally sung by Bruno Mars.
Okay, that's really good. The soundtrack for that movie is really good. I didn't care for the movie when I saw it, but the soundtrack is really good. As we said, we do have new members. We have 1, 2, 3. I think we have 6 new members. 6 new members who popped into the group and joined us. We're happy to have them with us.
Very much.
We are up to 161. Yay! We have Stitched Blessings, who is Stacy, who we actually know in real life, so we're glad to have her with us. I'm not sure how we pronounce this. Marie, I think it is. Her name is Marie.
Maury.
I'm sorry if we're butchering that, Marie, but welcome aboard. We have Angie's Hip, who is Andrea, and I've known her for a while.
Angie's Hip has been,
I've known her on Plurk, so it was cool to have her.
I know Angie wasn't a member.
Yeah, Andrea. And then there's, I'm not sure how this is pronounced. I think it's
Adana A.
It's Marina. Okay. Welcome, Marina.
You probably should have tried to figure out how to pronounce these before you said them on the podcast.
I did not wish to.
RDN Knitter.
I think that's Redhead Knitter. RDH
Knitter. Oh, I couldn't read it.
Carol. I think it means Redhead Knitter, but I'm not sure. And then there's Java Jenny, who I've heard of, but I've never met. So we're glad to have her with us.
Never met?
Yeah, well, never had. I don't think I've ever been in a group with her before. Mm. And it's good to have her with us, along with everybody else. It's exciting to see you in quotes. And if you see me looking off to the side, that's because that's where my Kindle Fire is.
Mine's on my lap right now.
I may be moving that because the different location has forced us to put things in different places, and I don't have my glasses, so it's hard for me to see there. So.
And also for me, my Kindle's kind of running low on juice. I had to have it. I can't leave it open the entire time. I have to flip it closed, flip it open.
Okay, did you want to handle the giveaway now?
Yeah, let's just do that now.
We have closed... You did not lock it. I locked it.
Oops.
We have closed the 150-member giveaway.
I wonder if you took off the sticky, though.
I didn't. I left it there. I know I left it there, but...
Well, keep speaking.
Anyway, you don't have to do that. That doesn't have to be done this instant.
Nope, I'm thinking of it now, so it must
She's
be done
She's a pain in the patootie. We have 7 prizes. We're really excited about that. We weren't sure how many prizes we would have. And we have a mixture of old members and new members picking up things, so that's exciting. So I'm going to leave that to you.
Okay.
You have the list. I have the list as well, but you might as well read them.
There we go.
Yes. Because I did the drawing. So. Mm-hmm.
We did the drawings earlier because there were so many.
Okay, so we pre-drew, and actually, I just always feel like pre-drawing works better.
Well, especially when we have so many, because we don't just usually have like one or two. We like to give as many as we can. So we have 7 prizes, and it would take a while.
Yeah, we take long enough as it is without drawing during the podcast. Anyway, first winner is post number 3, who is L.M. E. Cole, and she won the set of straight needles in the case. So
these have never been used. We did put them in the case, but they have never been used.
They're clovers.
They're clover wood
needles.
Straight needles. So, Linda, I think her name is Linda. L.M.
E. Cole.
E. Cole, please PM one of us with your address, because we don't have it, and we want to send this out to you. Congratulations.
Okay, the next post to win was post number 10, who is Nikki 18229, and she won the Patton's Stretch Socks yarn. So, very pretty color, and there's
approximately a total of like 770 or 750 yards or something like that. Should be enough to make a pair of socks if you knit.
There's 239 yards in each one.
Yeah.
So.
Yeah. And I thought I had 3 of them, unless this was given to me. If I find a third one, you'll be getting a third one.
Yeah.
If it was given to me, you'll be getting 2. Okay. So we hope you enjoy that. Congratulations.
Then the next post to win was number 18, who is Rose Bob. And she won the No Makers Merino Top. Darkwing Duck colorway, and this is beautiful. I haven't had a chance to spin this particular colorway up. I've determined I really you're gonna see the price.
Why don't we turn it up into the color better? You can see all the colors. It's gorgeous.
Yeah, this is something that I think is gonna be very gorgeous spun up. Sorry. I've determined I don't enjoy spinning.
Yeah, we want to make it quite clear that Amanda from No Makers makes an extremely, she dyes beautifully, and her
fiber
is beautiful.
It's just that I don't enjoy spinning, so I'd rather that someone else get some enjoyment out of this instead of me just hoarding this in my room.
Because it's absolutely gorgeous. If I spun, I would take it from her, but I just don't like to spin.
So, this is beautiful. Darkwing Duck. For those of you who remember the, what was
Darkwing
it?
Duck.
Was it a 90s cartoon, or was it 80s?
No, I think it was 90s, early 90s, mid-90s. We were in England.
I mean, I knew we grew up with it.
We were in England. So this is, it would have to be in the 90s then, because you were born in the mid-80s.
Mm-hmm.
This has, you can see the silver and the cut. I think it's gray in here.
It's white, silver,
and
red,
and purple.
Silver purple.
And dark purple. It's beautiful. And black, I think, is in here. But anyway, so, okay. Next.
Sorry, I'm thirsty. Then, the next winner is 31.
Oh, before we forget, we need your addresses, both the last two winners. And yes, Rosebud, we probably have yours, but please send it back to us.
So, anyway, the next winner is number 31, who is Stitch Blessings, and this is for her first post ever on Ravelry. And she won the Ironstone Warehouse yarns.
These are cotton, Stacy, but they're very soft, okay? I won these.
She can't see the color.
Bought these from Craftsy, and it was a surprise bag, and it's just not my colors. But I love the yarn. I kept the colors that were mine that I liked. So I think you'll like this.
And it looks like they work together.
Yeah, I think they work really well together. If you wanted to make like a lightweight shawl or a lightweight cowl or something, I think it would work really well. Okay, so Stacy, I need your address.
Then number 15.
Okay, which one?
The winner of the No Makers Merino Top Hank McCoy colorway is Hank's mom.
Yes, and we did not plan this.
We did not plan this.
This is funny.
Yeah, we were like, oh yeah, well, she likes blues and stuff. This really works. Yeah, Hank's mom should totally get this. And I thought about it. I was like, oh, Hank's mom just won Hank McCoy.
Yes. So please PM us with your address.
This
Hank's
is
mom.
An absolutely gorgeous colorway, and it really does look like basically you took Hank McCoy, the Beast from X-Men's fur, and got ready to spin it up. I have the other one of this because I did start spinning the other one. So if I ever go back to spinning, it's all my spindle. Mm-hmm. But I barely touched. There's so much in here. There's 4 ounces.
Amanda is a nerd first class, mm-hmm. and she gets the colors for the superheroes or whatever it is she's doing spot on. She's just really, really good. So
this really does make me think of Hank McCoy.
And I don't have anything to write no makers down on. Because I didn't bring any paper.
There's paper right there.
No, that's my coupon.
The next winner, Hank's mom. I know we have your address somewhere probably, but still send us.
I'm not sure that we do. Because we might have, last time she won, she might have won a pattern.
Okay.
Well, so we need addresses, yes.
Next winner is number 24, who is Simum. And she won the No Makers Merino Top Darkwing Duck in Darkwing Duck colorway. Someone is going to be getting the Darkwing Duck that has the open-ish one. It arrived to me open.
Yeah, it hasn't been used.
The package got torn.
It'll be put in another bag.
Yeah. And that's how it arrived to me. I think that it got torn in transit.
Uh-huh.
But... like you can see, a very nice color. And then the final winner of the last No Makers Top Darkwing Duck colorway is Cappy913.
Yay!
Cappy, our co-host for the sweater along. You have won 4 ounces of awesomeness.
And yes, Cappy, I know you have your address, but send it to us anyway because I'm kind of OCD about that. Well, I guess I'm actually OC because of D's disorder.
Yeah, you're not disorder.
I'm OC about this. Please, all of our winners, we congratulate you. Please PM either me or Talia with your address and your name so we can send these out to you. Just give us a little bit of time because the weather's been kind of dicey and her schedule has been strange. We have to box it all up. We will get it out to you as soon as we can.
Yeah, I've been averaging about 4 to 3 hours of sleep.
Yeah, so just get us your address, and as soon as we have your addresses, we will try to package all these in different envelopes and boxes and things and get them out to you. Congratulations.
Yay.
We're happy for you guys. The sweater along?
Yes. Sweater along is still going strong. We're doing it with the Knit Nerd Podcast. This is Cappy913, also known as Cappy.
And before you go any further with that, I want to let you then know about 10 hours or less.
Okay.
10 hours or less, George, who is a wonderful designer.
That's not a reflection on George. I'm just really tired.
Sure it isn't. He knows. George is a fantastic designer who does knit and crochet items, and he has very generously given us 3 patterns, one for each of 3 winners, for the sweater along. And those of you who have already won a pattern from him from the last,
you know, there's a lot,
you know,
available.
There's a lot available, and he is doing new things, and his patterns are awesome. I love them.
And apparently he designs sweaters, but he doesn't do it in 10 hour or less.
Yes, I was in conversation with him just before the podcast because he had offered this very generously to us, and I was saying he could do a sweater with us, and he was saying he used to do sweaters. He's a designer.
Oh, he used to. Okay.
He used to do sweaters, but any sweaters, and I'm sure he still does, but any sweaters that he would do for 10 hours or less would have to be 10 hours, which means it would be huge and bulky, and you know, because you'd have to use the great big yarn. So we had it was a funny conversation. It was really nice. But George, we appreciate it. You know, we appreciate it. We're very excited about it, and you guys are super lucky.
Mm.
Truly.
I need to make some of those bibs at some point.
Mm-hmm.
But
I go ahead and finish about the sweater along.
Yes. Actually, yeah.
I'm having chai tea, in case you're wondering. I mean,
I don't think anyone was wondering. Everyone knows what you're drinking.
One of these days, I'm going to bring my cup out here, and I'm going to have water in it.
Ha. Okay. So, I'm sorry, guys. I am really tired.
She's been coming in from her shift. Excuse me. Yesterday. She came in from her shift, was supposed to run like 7 to 7. She came in at 10.
Yeah,
so
it's been really rough lately.
Please forgive us for being a little tired. This is the only day we can podcast, and we probably will be podcasting on Tuesday from now on. It just seems to work better.
Yeah, because if I do get off on time, it means I can actually get sleep on Monday.
Oh, you wanted to say about iTunes.
Oh, yeah. Let's finish the sweater along.
Okay. Okay. Yeah.
Because we got started and we've been around.
I'm just all over.
I don't have your energy level. Okay.
I'm just all over. I have a headache. So.
Well, I don't have your energy level, so we can't go bopping around.
Can't go bopping around.
There's tissues.
I don't know. 1 second. Keep talking.
Keep talking. Don't stop.
There's
talking.
Tissues.
Okay. Yeah. We are a little bit all over the place because I am running on more sleep than she is, but not the sleep I'm used to. So. This will be interesting.
Okay. Sorry, I apologize, guys. Sweater along. It's still running strong. We do it with Cappy913, Kathy of the Knit Nerd podcast. Mm-hmm. And it runs from January 1st to March 30th.
Although if you started the Hallelujah or whatever. We're giving people, since we allowed the Hallelujah to be started Christmas.
It was the day after Christmas.
Day after Christmas. Whatever sweaters you started the day after Christmas, because
as long as they were not finished before January 1st.
Right, as long as they weren't, finished by before January 1st, they would be allowed for the prize.
And you can post progress pictures as long as you only post one progress picture per project each
week.
Although, if you finish a project, you can still post that project that week.
And we're
i.e., if you worked on the Hallelujah and Jenny's cardigan, for example, during the week, you could post a progress picture for the Hallelujah and the Jenny's cardigan. But then if you finished the Hallelujah during the same week, you could also post the finished picture for the Hallelujah.
And it's been really active in there. I'm really excited about it. We have people doing 2 and 3 sweaters at a time, which is really awesome. If
I have infected them.
She's got me doing more than one sweater at a time. I have 3 sweaters. One of them is in hibernation, but
deep hibernation.
Yes, but I have another one that's itching to get on the one you're doing right now. That I'm itching to get on the needles.
Mm-hmm.
But
I have 5 again.
Yeah, I have a feeling that I'll have 3 by the time the sweater along is done. But
I'm sorry, guys.
I was going to say something about the sweater along. Oh, for those of you who are new, who have just joined us, or maybe don't remember, we are co-hosting with Kathy, as Talia said. You can double dip with Kathy's group. We can double dip back and forth. Just make sure you're a member of both groups.
Yeah.
The rules are slightly different, so make sure you check with Kathy's rules.
I think Kathy has a limit on baby sweaters.
On baby sweaters, yeah.
But we don't.
And we don't allow anything that's not worn by a human.
Yeah, it has to be worn by a person.
The other thing is, Sock Money has also allowed us to triple dip into hers. So
her sweater long is a different kind of sweater long, though. I don't think it runs as long.
Yes, it does.
It does?
It's January. I believe it's January to March.
Oh, okay.
Or January to the end of February. Whatever. It's January to March, I believe. So you can double dip there as well, but you have to be a member of her group. And again, the rules are different over there. Mm-hmm. So
Because she's not running. She just happened to be running a sweater long at the same
time. Right. And so she was very gracious about letting us all kind of dip into each other's
sweater alongs,
which is fun. It's fun. The more the merrier. Just make sure that you're a member of all the groups if you want to be in all the groups for the prizes.
Yeah. So.
And yes, I talk with my hands. I'm half Italian. Yes. My goodness.
So next is I wanted to talk to y'all about where the podcast is being. Many of you, I'm sure, watch on Blip or on Blip. On iTunes. A lot of podcasters, probably most of us, have been receiving emails at this point saying that Blip is no longer supporting iTunes, or iTunes is no longer supporting Blip, however the heck it works. Basically, Blip is not doing the coding for us anymore to get us on iTunes. So we had to find an ulterior way.
Alternative,
thank you. That was the one I wanted to say. An alternative way to get on iTunes. So if you currently listen to us on iTunes, your current subscription will not get you the newest podcast. You need to look for us again on the iTunes store, and 2 Pinhook and Needles podcasts will show up. The one that was most recently updated, and that also has a picture that says Pinhook and Needles on it, will be the one that you need to subscribe to. The other one, the one that you're probably currently subscribed to, has the old Nurse's Needles picture on it.
Right. The picture on the pen hook and needles, it has pen hook and needles, but I think it also has a picture from our podcast group, doesn't it?
Yeah, it has the red... Yeah.
The red knitting.
Well, it has when I was working on the Holoha.
Right.
It has my Holoha on there.
Right. Is that the same as what we have on the...
Yes,
yeah.
Is.
So you'll recognize it. You want to make
it
sure...
It actually has a pen hook and needles.
A pen hook and needles. And it'll say pen hook and needles. So,
yeah.
So if you want to continue to watch us on iTunes as opposed to YouTube or WordPress, you want to make sure that you go to iTunes and research for us and resubscribe for us under pen hook and needles.
Because... The old one with the picture of the nurse's needles is not going to be updated anymore because that was the one that was run through Blip. And we've moved to a new host, Hipcast.
Yeah.
Costs a little something, but at least I know they'll be consistent and I know we can get on iTunes.
And we really want to keep providing this for you. We enjoy it. As long as you guys are happy and enjoying it, we want to keep doing this. So Ty found one that was quasi-reasonable, and...
I basically went with whatever was working for Fivertown.
Right.
So.
Right. So.
And if it's a little fuzzy, I'm still trying to figure things out with Hipcast. We've only used it once.
Right. I noticed that it was a little fuzzy the last time, but...
But it might have been lighting in the room,
It might have
too.
Been the lighting. It might have been switching, because I think, didn't you pull that one from Blip to...
No.
You didn't? You just went directly?
Oh, directly.
Okay. Well, it'll get, you know, it wasn't overly fuzzy, but it wasn't as clear as we normally are. So, just bear with us, please. We're... Tie it by we, I mean she is working out the technical kinks.
Yeah.
So, okay.
Alrighty, so on to Project You First.
Me first? Okay.
Yep.
Alright, well this is I've actually done quite a bit of work on this. I only have two projects that are in progress. This is my, I keep losing my hook. I swear I'm going to have to tie a leash on it or something.
You're gonna have to move this out of the way. I keep leaning on the prizes.
This
so
is my...
Come on, back to the screen.
Well,
it's me right. I keep leaning on the prizes. And
well, you cannot go to sleep.
Why not?
Because I do not wish it.
Why not?
Oh. Let me see here. I'm sorry for the interruption. Okay.
It's behind me.
Oh.
Exactly what I was concerned about.
Thanks, Mom. Yes. Okay. I cannot find my hook at the moment. I know I had it. I just don't know where it went. I did quite a bit of work on this time. I've been using it for my TV project. And I just have to be careful not to lose this stitch because I can't find my hook. Here is the little doohickey, as Dawn calls it, where I was. So I've made...
I can't remember the last time I marked where I was
quite a
project.
Bit.
Probably because it just confuses me. Because usually when I mark something, it has a purpose.
So you can see this is really long. It's probably about, I'm 5'6", just about, so this is probably a little bit longer than 5'6", this way. And I haven't decided how big it's going to be up and down yet. But it's fun. It's something I can do when I don't have to, I can't pay attention because I need to talk to my husband, and, you know, or whatever, spend family time, or watch the well, we don't have television. We got rid of our television.
Is that effective immediately?
Yes, it's been effective since the 25th. We decided that we weren't going to pay that much for television anymore. We didn't like what was on television anyway, so we are sans TV. We just do videos
you guys
and movies.
I think you guys started that during my... long work stretch, though.
Yeah.
I didn't really notice.
So, I mean, we watch movies and things like that, and this is what I do when we watch the movies. And in some ways, you know...
Have we been doing a lot of the Wild Wild West for the...
we've been doing a lot of the Wild Wild West. We have a lot of box sets and things like that, and we'll
I have Rawhide that we barely touched. We could start from the beginning.
Yep. We have a whole bunch of things. We like our Westerns. We like our science fiction and that kind of stuff.
No, we don't like our Westerns.
No, not at all.
And so I have my one season of The Virginian.
Anyway, I did make quite a bit of progress on this. It's my own pattern, and I'm using an eye hook. I'm using Impeccable is the solid pink. And this, you can probably tell me what this is better than I can. This is Yarnby Soft Secret, I think it's called. It's the Danielle Yarn and the Dawn colorway. So, go ahead, Ty, your turn.
Okay, so I barely worked on this at all. This has not been a good stretch for me for getting stuff done. Work has been kind of wiping me out. Basically, I've been getting sleep where I can and stay at work late. This is a yawn.
I wish I could find my... I'm sorry, I'm being antsy, but I don't know where my...
Oh, I didn't realize I was in the middle of a row. Oh, well.
She's pulling a Lindsay.
I am working on Popcorn, which is the name of the project. It is the Hallelujah pattern by Mel Ski. I'm using US 4 needles and mustache yarn and fibers, Hell of a Skein in the Polani colorway. And initially I'd started for me, and someone, I forget who is saying, I haven't answered a lot of people because it's been my long work stretch, and to be quite honest, when you were, well, I guess people work longer hours, but I was working approximately, it's anywhere from 12 to 15 hours when you have to stay over.
I think it was Allison who was teasing you.
Yeah, whoever it was picking on me, saying that I decided that this yellow wasn't quite my color. It's really pretty, and I enjoy working on it, but I think it would be prettier on Davina. And she's like, well, it's the same as the other yellow you're starting. This one is a little lighter. It's more like Popcorn. Whereas the other one is a deeper yellow, and I'm actually going to pull
it. I would actually call it a brighter yellow, even, the other one. Kind of a more, I hesitate to use the word robust, but...
Look at this. It's different.
It's quite a bit different.
Just so you can have a general idea. This one is just... This is more like sunlight, I guess. Or this is more like buttercups. Or just plain butter.
Yeah, butter, maybe.
So, popcorn, butter.
Butter.
That's what I think of. And Davina does the pastels a lot better than I do. Also, she likes them a lot better than I do. I've always liked more of the flame colors. So this will be very nice on her.
She'll love it.
So it's size 32 because she's a bitty thing. I got a little tighter than gauge, which works. Not a little tighter. I got more stitches for the gauge, just a little bit more. I probably could have gone down a needle size, but I was like, man, it's fine. So it'll be fine for her.
She doesn't like things really tight anyway.
No, she doesn't. So. I got more stitches for gauge. No, I would have to go up a needle size. Because I got 27. Oh, no, I got less for gauge. So, yeah, I would have had to go down. It's fine. It'll fit her fine. So, yeah, not much has been done on it. Worked a little bit on it in church.
Looks pretty. And actually, she didn't work that much because she kept falling asleep.
I was really tired. I was a little concerned about whether or not I was going to make it to work that day.
I would have driven you.
I got to the stop sign. I almost didn't see someone coming.
That's not good.
No, I tell you, I was really wiped out that day.
You're lucky your parents and your sister pray for you to get to work. Oh, I can do it.
I wasn't doing well that day.
Mm-hmm.
But obviously I got to and from work, and this didn't get much work on it at all.
That's so pretty, though.
So, it'll be really nice on her when it finally gets done.
They're going to call this Winners and Yawns.
Mm-hmm.
Did you get the pertinent with the needles and everything?
Yeah.
Okay. My other project, and right now I'm calling it, it's the sweater that might become a cardigan is what I'm calling it right now. It's my first knitted sweater from the Craftsy class.
And is the back the same regardless?
Yeah, the back is the same. And I actually made some progress on this. Oh, that's my swatch. I finished the, if I can find it, I finished the ribbing that was on the size 8, and I moved on to the stockinette, which is on the 10s, and then I realized that somehow I must have miscounted or something, and I have a couple of sections, I'll show you as soon as I get this done. A couple of stitches, actually 5 to be exact, where my
it's more than five, it's like 10 because you did it on both the knitted and the purl.
Okay. Where I did, I flipped the stitches and I thought, oh, I can live with it, I guess. I mean, it's not that noticeable.
But if it's going to bother you.
I don't know if it'll bother me. I want you guys to take a look at it. I think I'm going to cast on another pair of eights, start the ribbing again, and then I'll look at this again. And if I can live with it, I'm doing the pullover as opposed to the cardigan, then this will already start it for the front. Or for the back. But I don't know if you can see. Do you see the difference?
No, you're just doing it the wrong way around. You can really see it.
Okay.
So what she did is, okay,
there it is.
I want to show a difference. You see where she's supposed to be going, purl two, knit two, purl two, knit two. Well, here she goes, instead of purling two, she knits two, then she purls two, then she knits two, then she purls two. So she reversed it.
And I corrected myself.
Later.
I'm not sure.
It might have been that you stopped in the middle, went to do something, and I forgot what you were doing.
Yeah, it could be. So, I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to recast on another size. Well, I have my eights. My eights are free. I'll redo the ribbing and put this aside for a little bit, and then by that time I'll determine if I can live with this or not. I have a feeling that if I get through the 2x2 ribbing and onto stockinette without any mistakes, I'll probably just rip this out. And because I don't know if I want to do a cardigan or if I want to do the pullover. So it is. I have mentioned that I'm using the US 8s and the US 10s.
And I mean, it's looking really good, except for that little section.
You can't really tell, but I can tell.
Yeah, if it's enough that's going to bother you, you really don't want your first knit sweater to have something that is going to really bother you.
And I'm really liking the fabric. It's really nice. I think if I had done it, if I had gotten gauge in the needle size that I was supposed to get gauge in, I don't think I would have liked the fabric as much. I think it would have been too dense for me, because I get hot. You know, I get cold and I get hot. Yeah, you know, I'm in that age. I get tropical vacations, right?
Yeah. I get cold and hot. I'm not in that age.
So,
but that might just be a lovely night shift.
Yeah. And the yarn I'm using is, I think it's Woolies, Lion Brand Woolies. And like I said, the 8 and the 10 needles, US 8s and 10s. And I do like the pattern. It's not difficult to follow so far. And for me, with knitting, that's saying something. So, yeah, that's that.
Okay. So, those are your two?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. We didn't work on a whole lot of anything.
We had a lot going on with her birthday and stuff like that.
The one thing that I really, if I worked on anything, it was usually this. It's the Goldenrod project, which is an inland pattern by Jane Richmond. This is really good for
mindless knitting.
Not even just mindless knitting. It's a quick. You could see the progress.
Instant gratification.
Instant gratification. Thank you. It's the inland pattern by Jane Richmond. I used US 13s, and I'm now using US 11s.
And this is the pattern I was saying.
And I love this chunky and the crocus colorway, size 36 for me.
This is the pattern I was telling you about, that if I end up with a third one on the needles, this would be it.
And the funny thing is, I've never considered myself much of a yellow person, but I've been in flame colors lately. And the two products I'm working on the most right now are yellows.
Is this top down?
It is top down. Yeah, here is the collar.
Oh, that's pretty. I like the shawl collar. That's nice.
So it's got a shawl collar, and I'm currently working my way down the shoulders.
That is really pretty.
It's really pretty. And the nice thing about this pattern is that it works the buttonholes in as it goes along. It's the first time I've had a pattern that does that. And I've always said if I wanted to design a sweater, I'm not going to right there. I just don't have the mind or the energy.
We don't have the time right now.
Don't have the time, the mind, or the energy. But if I was to ever do that, I've always said that I wanted to do something where the buttonholes are always already built in. And see, she already built the buttonholes in.
This designer is really good. And she's exciting when you listen to her talk about her patterns and things. She's very low key, but she's just exciting.
Yeah, and I'm very happy with this pattern. I'll have to look at more of her patterns later, mm-hmm. but I have a feeling this will be one of my happy, comfy sweaters. And I'm thoroughly enjoying the next, what do I do with the...
You know, if we both finish that before the retreat in September, we can wear it, and we'll be wearing flame colors, then I'll make mine in red. Because I already have a blue sweater, and Ty is making me a blue sweater, so I don't need another blue sweater.
Well, in reality, for retreat, the problem isn't going to be what, you know, whether or not I get to wear hand knits. The problem is going to be
which
one.
Yeah.
Because I'll have the green sweater, the orange sweater, the red sweater, the poncho, hopefully probably the yellow sweater, and then whatever other sweater I haven't finished before that time. That's a whole year to go. You know?
I do have, before we get into other things, I do have a question for you guys. I just heard that an acquaintance of mine from our church, she had gone through some kind of cancer, and she's a cancer survivor. But I just heard through our prayer chain that she is going back to chemo. So I'm assuming she has had a
relapse.
And I've been looking for shawls or shrugs or something that can work up fairly quickly that are pretty soft, maybe worsted or possibly even bulky, possibly. That's not too intricate because I want to get it done quickly. It could be knitted or crocheted if you have any suggestions that I can look at, because I'm just having a hard time finding something that'll work up quickly and will not make me tear my hair out while I'm trying to do other things, but still make her feel loved.
Because chemo makes them
cold. So I'm looking at ponchos, shrugs, shawls, anything like that that you think might, you know, make her feel like she's being hugged. I thought about a shawl. I have a couple in mind, but I'd like to have more suggestions kind of to bounce off.
My concern with the poncho is, you know, if she ends up flipping from hot and cold like you sometimes do when you're not feeling well, mm-hmm. a poncho might not be the best.
Right. I mean,
because you have to pull it over her head, whereas a shawl, she just let it drop.
Right. And there are some shawls that have, they're like shrugs. I've seen them where they have the shawls, they actually have the sleeves, and then it's shawl-shaped in the back.
Mm-hmm.
And I don't know if that, I mean, she could still sew that off like a cardigan if she wanted
yeah.
to. So any suggestions would be greatly appreciated. I'm not sure when I'll start it. Depends on what I find and, you know, that kind of thing. I appreciate your help if you have any ideas.
Okay. Alright. I don't have any finished objects. Do you?
I do. I believe this is Allison. Yes, Allison's going to get lots of ear burns today. I think Allison's fault. I think it was Allison. If it wasn't, I apologize. Whoever it is, they know who they are.
And I have nothing to write on either.
They have been very nice. They know I like toys, and of course everybody else. And so, and the group likes toys. And so she put these patterns, suggestions, free pattern suggestions on the thread, one of the threads. And this was one of them. And I just love it. His name is Hunch.
Can you pull back a little bit? You've seen
Hunch. Hunch. From Rockadoodle is what I call him, Hunch. Because when I was making him, I was asking my husband and my daughter what I should call him. And Davina's like, Hunch. I said, Hunch. She said, yeah, from Rockadoodle. So this is Hunch. It's from the Baby Owl pattern by Little Muggles. And I believe it's a free pattern. I don't think I paid for this. And I just had a blast. He's super quick to make, super easy to make. It only took me 2 days. And that was in my usual style, starting things at night. So, I just love him.
He turned out really cute.
He was supposed to be a beanbag. I didn't want to make him a beanbag, you know, with beans on the bottom. But he still stands.
You aren't going to be able to see how he stands.
He's probably not going to want to do it now in here, but see, he stands just
well,
fine.
You're asking him to perform.
Yes, he doesn't like to perform. So anyway, that's my finished object. He was an unexpected finished object. I started him in the middle of the week, and he was finished.
You mean we're on the podcast, kiddo?
Yeah. Okay, so that is Hunch.
Okay, so then we go into royalties. And sorry, it's longer than I thought. We're going longer than I thought. I was going to say, sorry, this is going to be a short one because I...
Oh, we are going further along. It was all the prize thread, yeah. Okay,
I'm ready to start.
Okay, I'll go to the next on the Hooks and Needles, which I already
Say royalties.
I already asked you about that, and that was the shawls, the pair of shawls, if you have any ideas. So that's all I have to say about that. And royalties, did you want to say yours, or do you want me to say mine?
Go ahead, start.
Okay, my birthday is the day after tomorrow. And I got an early birthday gift from Talia. And this time I'm not going to show you the coupon code. This is from Dragonfly Fibers. Talia was very nice, and she got me a $50 gift certificate.
Are you sure you're not showing the code?
Nope.
Okay.
Dragonfly Fibers. See, the code is right here. $50 gift certificate to Dragonfly Fibers. I'm really excited about that.
She only shows you the code when the quantity is greater than 50.
Yeah. So I am really excited. Now I have in my stash, so to speak, Miss Babs yarn and Dragonfly Fibers yarn to use when I see fit. So I'm really excited about that. Thank you very much, Talia. And I think my husband's going to get stuck taking me to the local yarn store this weekend.
Speaking of birthday gifts, after our last podcast, like almost as soon as we finished recording, I got a birthday gift in my Ravelry box from Laura Mag, and it is the Granville sweater. Let me see if I can.
That was nice.
It's really nice, and I'm not sure if I have a good picture of it here. It's reminiscent of the Vivian a bit. Ah, good. So.
Is it the same designer?
No.
Oh, that's pretty.
So, there's the back of the hood.
Oh, isn't that gorgeous?
I think the nice thing about it is it has more stockinettes. Because I love the Vivian, but it definitely, there were definitely days where I couldn't work on it because I had to focus because there were like five different charts. It was like there's fewer charts, but there's still enough cable to keep me interested.
Without the color, if you look at the black and white of the hood without the color, it looks like chainmail. It's so cool.
I might have to do it in a gray or something.
Oh, that would be cool. It's beautiful.
Although, I might do it in that blue that I have, no matter how much yarn I have.
The one you keep saying, the blue is like that. Is that your blue dress?
No, I just can't figure out what I'm going to do with it. It's a superwash worsted. It's a very nice pattern. Thank you very much, Laura Mag. I really appreciate it. I am not going to cast on a sixth sweater right now. I have to finish
one,
and I'm not going to cast on another fifth one after that. I'm going to then finish something else.
Uh-huh. This is me believing her. Uh-huh. Okay.
Because I had five sweaters on the needles.
And since when did that stop you? Oh, there we go.
Well, at least I didn't, after I finished the Vivian, I didn't cast out another sixth one. I waited a little bit and finished another one before I started another one.
Okay, our autobiography.
Oh, I still have royalties.
Oh, you do? Oh, go ahead. I don't have any more.
Okay, so.
Oh, yes, I haven't seen this yet except for the one skein.
Okay, so first, I got my needle set. I used some gift cards to get another one of the twist, because I absolutely have fallen in love with these needles, the twist red lace set from Taigu.
Mm-hmm.
And I had picked up like a bunch of extra needle points and a bunch of extra cables. So, I can have as much. I can work with all Taigus if I want to. Although I do love my Nick Pick still, Taigus are currently my favorites. It's evidence by the fact that almost everything I've been working on recently has been using Taigus.
See, I want to get the Nick Picks Caspians. I want to get those.
Oh, those are the blue ones?
Mm-hmm. They're beautiful, so I think I might pick those up.
And then I got a sweater kit. Craftsy had a 40% off sale. The thing is, at first, I wasn't able to get in. I had decided that, okay, I narrowed it down to two sweaters. The one sweater, the colors I wanted, well, actually, the kit wasn't available anymore. I guess they sold out of all the yarn, so I wasn't able to get my first choice of sweater. And then I fell in love with the sleeves for this one.
I love those.
I really like...
Take a look at how high the ribbing goes.
The ribbing goes up to there. And I love tight ribbing at my wrists. So.
Well, it also means that you should be able to push it up if you want to.
Mm-hmm.
Because it's stretchy.
But that's the pattern that I wanted. And for some reason, the 40% off for Craftsy just would not apply to the pattern. Actually, the first time I tried to apply it to any after the first time I tried to apply it to anything, it wouldn't apply to anything in the Craftsy store. So I contacted Craftsy, and they not only applied the 40% to this sweater kit, they also applied it to the extra skein of yarn I picked up.
Craftsy is
so
fantastic.
I am very happy with their service.
If you haven't done business with Craftsy in the past, you really should. If you need classes, if you want to look at
patterns. I love them.
Craftsy is absolutely fantastic. They have great customer service. They put out great classes.
But this is the Everyday Hoodie. It's designed by Sylvia Hager. I've never worked any patterns before. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, at first I thought it was a shawl pattern as well. A shawl cat. That shawl collar as well, but it's not. And I am the yarn that came with it is a worsted cotton put out by Blue Sky Alpacas. I've never worked with cotton before. The colorway is, blah.
Blah? Is that a technical term?
I know the colorway. I'm just too tired to think of it right now.
I forget what you said it was. Graphite? No.
No. Charcoal, I think, is probably what it was. But it's very nice.
It's really pretty. It's coming fairly true to color.
Yeah, and so it's going to be a nice dark sweater. I'm not going to start it right away.
And a nice winter sweater to wear.
Yeah, and it's cotton, so it should be.
And this is cotton, but it's soft.
Yeah, it's surprising, because I've never worked with cotton. One of the reasons I haven't is because I've heard it's rough on the hands.
I would work with this cotton in a heartbeat. I'm used to, dishy yarn, which is my favorite one to work with at this point, Knit Picks, is not like this. It's I would use dishy yarn for dishcloths and towels and things like that. It's a very good yarn, toys, things like that. But this I would actually wear.
So, it's very nice. I've been, it says hand wash, dry clean. Oh, I can dry clean it. That's interesting.
Oh, that's cool.
So.
Yeah, because all cotton will shrink.
Very, very nice sweater kit. And I need to stop looking at the kits on Craftsy, because I never have really bought many kits on Craftsy, and 2 weeks in a row I bought kits.
Yeah, I don't do well with kits because I don't get gauged. I have to buy extra yarn and stuff like that. So, and I never do the alongs. I never finish them. I'm really bad about that. You might be better than I am with that.
Slightly. I did finish the whole Aloha.
Not on time, but I finished it.
I mean, I was better at it in the beginning where I wasn't doing so many projects all at one time.
Mm-hmm.
But, okay. I'm going to move on. I don't think we have much in autobiography that we haven't already talked to with, comics and...
No, I started watching documentaries. I watched one before I went to bed on the Rosie the Riveters during World War II. They grabbed a bunch of older ladies who did the jobs in the factories, who did things like broke translated codes, and who did things like welded, and all these different jobs that they ended up doing when the guys went to war, and they talked about their experience of working during World War II, the Rosie the Riveters.
Right, that would have been interesting.
It was very interesting. I reposted it to Facebook. I found a place where I can watch free documentaries.
Cool.
And then I watched one on Vlad the Impaler.
He's creepy. yeah.
Well, the annoying thing is that it was talking about, right toward the end, we were starting to talk about the medical condition that could have caused people to think of vampires. There's this medical condition that if they spend too much time in the sun, their skin will actually start to burn. If they spend like a couple minutes in the sun, they'll start burning.
Is that like albinos?
No, they aren't albinos. They actually get a yellowish tint, and both parents have to have this genetic trait. And one way to help it is to get blood transfusions or to have bloodletting, that kind of thing. And apparently part of the disorder has the gums pull back from the teeth a bit, and it'll make their teeth shine a little bit.
Oh, that's interesting.
And they were just getting into that part of it when the end of the documentary skipped. And I was like, no, that's the part I'm really interested in.
That's why it skipped.
So I didn't get to learn more about that, which made me sad. But apparently with all the inbreeding during that time period, it was far more likely to have
a father who had it and a mother who had the traits to produce kids who had the traits.
Well, you gotta wonder if that's why you had that hemophilia
at
that time.
Garlic used to actually
help it?
No. Garlic, the fumes or whatever, would actually really affect them and make them go into these rages where they would attack people.
Oh, wow.
So there's a little kernel of truth, not necessarily that they would drink your blood, but...
Well, the garlic was supposed to ward them off.
It frightened them, so if they even saw the garlic, they would run away from it because it really affected them. I'm not sure if it burned their skin.
It might. It's acidic, isn't it?
Yeah. And it wasn't so much that the garlic made them go insane. The condition could affect them mentally.
Right.
It made them a little unstable.
Huh.
Very interesting.
So that's basically that for autobiography. For writing, I did about a 500-word free write, finally, and that was nice. I wasn't exactly happy with it, but it was down on paper, and I'm not going to beat myself up on it.
I haven't had the brain power to write.
Yes, I know. And I'm also, I did a week of prompting for the CH Percolator Coffee House for Writers. I had an assigned week. I am in the middle of doing a substitute week because the person who is supposed to do the week, I don't know if she's having computer problems or I hope she's feeling well because she's just not been seen or heard for. She's the one who's in charge of the prompting. I'm thinking that she might not be feeling well or maybe her computer's down. So I'm
there's some nasty bugs going on.
Yeah, I hope she's all right. So I'll just take care of it for another week and see what happens. But I am doing that. I did a critique for a fellow writer, but other than that, my writing has been kind of at a standstill. I feel singularly uncreative at this particular point in time.
Your owl is very disappointed that you feel uncreative.
He's cute. But I am trying. I will keep trying to write. I also feel like my time is very cut up. In terms of being able to just sit down and do something. And I need to get away from the computer when I'm doing stuff, except that when I write, I'm on the computer. So I may have to try to go back to the old-fashioned handwriting for a while, provided I can actually read what I write, which is always a question mark. But other than that, I think that's it.
Yeah, pretty much.
I mean, I'm looking forward to
it. I had a freak out moment for a second. I was like, I hope we're recording, but we are.
Oh, I'm looking forward to this weekend because my husband said I can go anywhere I want to eat, and I can pretty much do what I want to do. Talia's going to be home until that evening around 5 or 6 when she'll go out with the boyfriend, and then we'll have...
Yeah, we're talking about going bowling.
Oh, that'll be fun. And then my husband, because he's a sweetheart, he's going to make me a birthday meal on Sunday. In our house, birthdays go almost a week.
Mm-hmm.
Sometimes they go longer if it's Davina.
Davina will milk it for a month or more.
But my husband's going to make me a caramel apple pie, which I love. We only have it twice a year, or once or twice a year. And then he makes me a pot pie for my birthday because we have that usually for my birthday and for Mother's Day because that's the only time.
I'm sure it's a little disappointing for him because when we were kids, when Davina and I were growing up, we used to always have cake, and Dad would decorate the cake. I don't mean just put a little flowers on it. He does cake artwork, and I might have to see if I can find some pictures to put at the beginning of the podcast.
Right, he's an artist, and he's a very good artist.
And he doesn't. It's not like he has. You know, you'll see the professionals where they actually have something over the top of the cake that they put the icing on top of. They're basically like tracing. No, Dad has a picture off to the side, and he is painting on the icing with other icing.
And
the best way to describe it. He's drawing and painting on the icing with icing.
And he mixes his own colors. He doesn't just stick to the colors. It's like watching someone take the oils or whatever, mix the oils, and then, you know, do whatever. He uses toothpicks, he uses whatever.
He is actually creating art with icing.
Mm-hmm.
But unfortunately, as I've gotten older, I know that I don't always want something sweet in the house.
Ty and I don't go for the cakes too much anymore. I have either my apple pie or I might have an angel food cake.
But Davina still wants the special icing on her cake.
Yeah, and then my husband, of course, when we do his cake, he, you know, we don't expect him to do his own. And he usually wants a pineapple upside down cake, which I make. So
Davina's really the only one who gets the special icing to her cake.
Sometimes when we have our baby Jesus cake for Christmas, we'll have a decorated cake, but usually we just have an angel food cake for that.
Yeah.
So, anyway, I'm looking forward to this weekend. It'll be fun. Hopefully the weather will cooperate and we'll get to do what we want to do. So on that note, unless you have anything else to talk about.
And I am very pleased that my battery lasted this long.
Yeah. We want to thank again 10 hours or less George for the 3 patterns that he is donating for the prize pot for the sweater along. That's very exciting. Thank
it
you
is.
Very much. And
all of the winners for the 150 members, please contact us.
Mm-hmm.
So we can get your prizes to you in some eventuality.
Yes, we don't want them in our house. We don't want them sitting up here taking space any longer than they have to. I don't want my husband saying, what is that doing on the couch?
Yeah.
Because if it goes back on our bookshelves, we won't be able to find it.
No.
So please get to us as soon as you can.
And I feel a lot less guilty having fiber I'm not going to use.
Mm-hmm.
I feel a lot better knowing that it's going to go to good homes.
Yeah, I am happy about
the actual spinners.
Getting things out to people who might actually use them. Then I can get things that I want to use and will use, as opposed, you know, not feel guilty about it, having stuff that's just sitting there and buying new stuff. So
I have like 6 different sweaters worth of yarn.
Well, I have just sweaters worth of yarn.
Well, no, more than 6. I'm sure I have at least 10 sweaters worth of yarn.
I think I have 2 or 3, but it's...
I eyeball her sweater.
She's coveting my sweater yarn. She can't have it. She can't have it. It's a blue-gray sweater that yarn that I've had, like, for, what, a couple of years now?
Uh-huh.
And not since I started knitting. So, no, she can't have that. It's mine.
Anytime she's like, well, I'm not really sure I'm going to get much new sweaters. I'm like, you know, I can always take that off your hands.
Not happening. Anyway.
I even offered to make her a sweater out of it.
I'll make my own sweater out of it. But anyway, that's basically it. We want to wish you a very good week, even if we are a day late. We will be on Tuesdays most likely from now on.
So it's not a day. And actually, we did it on Tuesday last week, too.
Did we?
Because remember, Thomas took me shooting on Monday.
Oh, that's right. So it'll probably be on Tuesday. It's just kind of a little easier for us. They'll know what day they're going out. We'll know what day we're doing this. And it'll be basically set. So that's good. And please check us out. Don't forget to resubscribe to us on iTunes if you want to continue to watch us on iTunes. We are on YouTube. We are on WordPress.
And then we embed into the thread on Ravelry as well.
And on Facebook. We're on Facebook. So just resubscribe if you continue to watch us on iTunes. We'd love to have you still watch us there. And
I know it's easier for me to watch on iTunes.
Me too. It is easier.
I'm not as caught up on my podcast as I'd like to be because I've been really getting into my history things again.
And I'm trying to figure out where everybody is still. So some people are coming to me from WordPress and Blogspot, and people are coming to me from other places. I have a lot of feeds coming in, but I don't know where they're all at. I have to keep looking at them. So anyway, we wish you a very good week of knitting and crocheting and whatever makes you happy. This is Pen, Hook, and Needles, episode 87. Right?
Yep.
And that's a wrap.